हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ़ यू। आई होप यू ऑल आर वेल। इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर आई एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट योर ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट सब्जेक्ट सिलेबस। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट इट। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, सब्जेक्ट कोड ऑफ दिस सब्जेक्ट इज 333-0001। दिस सब्जेक्ट इज कंसिडरिंग इन योर सेमेस्टर 3। हियर इज द टीचिंग स्कीम फॉर दिस सब्जेक्ट इज 2 लेक्चर्स पर वीक एंड द सब्जेक्ट क्रेडिट इज 2। योर एंड सेमेस्टर एग्जामिनेशन फॉर दिस सब्जेक्ट इज 70 मार्क्स एंड this examination will conduct by GTU. Then PA means progression assessment means 30 marks is considering as your internal marks. For this internal marks you have to give your mid examination and one assignment submission. The assignment will give you by me and you have to submit this assignment for your 30 marks. Then total 100 marks scheme for this HRM subjects. Then after, here is the course detail for your human resource management subject. Total 5 units are considering for this subject. So here is unit 1 is introduction. For introduction there are considering main 4 topics. First one, need and scope of human resource management in industrial environment. Second one is impact of human factor on productivity and industrial harmony. Third topic is importance of providing the need-based training to manpower. Fourth topic is quality of good supervisor. Second topic, or we can say your second unit, is human needs and relations and value. For this unit there are total 6 topics you have to study it. First one, importance of human resource in Indian philosophy. Second one, X and Y theory. Third one is Maslow's hierarchy need theory. Fourth topic is need of human relations and human values in industry and interdepartment and intra-department in organization. Fifth topic is good relation with supervisors and client. Sixth topic is desirable human values and their importance including ethics and moral value. Third topic or the third unit of your syllabus is behavioral dynamics. Means what? There are total 11 topics are considering in this unit. So first topic is need of intrapersonal competence. Second one is determinants of interpersonal behavior. Third topic is concept of intrapersonal orientation and attractiveness and its importance in human behavior. Fourth topic is concept of group dynamics. Fifth topic is dynamics of group formation. Sixth topic is types of groups. Seventh topic is role of team and organization. Desirable characteristics of team member. Ninth topic is concept and importance of positive attitude and openness of mind. Tenth topic is do's and don'ts of developing positive attitude. And the last topic of unit number 11, or we can say the 11th topic of this unit, is importance of mental health. Fourth unit title is leadership development. There are total 15 topics considering in unit number 4. So unit number 4 is lengthy than the other units. So there are the topics for this unit number 4 are: first one, various definitions of leadership. Second one, situational approach to leadership. Third topic is quality of good leader. Fourth topic is power, influence and compliance. Then fourth topic is influence of leadership. Sixth topic is technical to deal people, techniques to deal people effectively. Then case studies. In this subject, there are these various case studies are given in your textbook, but in the GTU examination, they cannot ask case studies. According to my observation and analysis for last 10 years paper, they cannot ask any time this case studies for your examination, but we also try to complete this case studies. So if GTU ask this case studies in your examination, you can easily solve it. Seventh topic is importance of resources management, like human, machine, material, method, money, time, information. Eighth topic is need, importance and types of organizational training. Ninth topic is need and importance of motivation. Tenth topic is changing role of supervisor as a facilitator and motivator. 11th topic is need, importance and use of guidance, mentoring, coaching and counseling. 12th topic is importance of problem solving and decision making in context of productivity, quality, cost consciousness and human relations and good achievement, or we can say what are the goal achievements. 13th topic is factor affecting decision making. 14th topic is types and process of decision making. 15th topic, which is the last topic of your unit number 4, is make the decision for given case and situation is considering case study. In this topic, the case given to you for any company or any organization, then after you have tried to solve it, that what are the solution for this the particular situation, then your fifth last topic is change and stress management. So there are 12 topics considering for this subject units. First one, need of for change. Second one, barriers to change, strategies and tools to manage for changes. Fourth topic is trade unions and their objectives. Fifth topic is constructive role of trade unions. in the goal setting and achievement of change management. Sixth topic is causes for conflicts and techniques to resolve the conflicts. Seventh topic is concept of stress. Eighth topic is causes for stress. Ninth topic is stress measuring techniques. 10th topic is need for relieving stress. 11th topic is technique to manage stress and case studies for this particular topic of stress. And 12th and last topic of your unit number 5 is self-management techniques. So here there are the your course detail for human resource management subject, and there are the suggested book or reference book for your particular subject. This subject's PDF I also post in your Google classroom, and if you have any query regarding the course details, you can ask me. Thank you.